And welcome to another edition of Talkline. I'm Zev Brenner, coming to you from the annual Chabad Children of Chernobyl dinner at Chelsea Piers in New York City. We're right back with our very special broadcast right after the following messages. Stay tuned.
The Hebrew University of Jerusalem is a monument to more than 20 centuries of Jewish reverence for learning, to the Jewish quest for knowledge, as exemplified by its founders, who included Albert Einstein, Chaim Weizmann, and Sigmund Freud. Today, the Hebrew University has rewarded the vision of those founders. It's the top-ranked educational institution in Israel, and the leading developer of Israel's greatest asset, its brain power. Israel is a tiny country, smaller than New Jersey, with only 0.1% of the world's population and virtually no natural resources. However, in intellectual achievement, it has very few peers. Per capita, it has the highest ratio of university degrees in the world. It's first in the world in biotech startups and first in the number of scientific papers produced. This is Israel's brain power at work. And the leading generator of that brain power is the Hebrew University of Jerusalem.
Hello, my name is Tova Feltschuh, and I've played many roles in my career, including Prime Minister Golda Meir. Like you, I've watched the news and felt helpless as the Katyusha rockets brought death and destruction to Israel's north. Rockets being launched from Gaza also threaten Israeli communities, but there is something we can do. Make a contribution today to American Friends of Magan David Adom Code Red Emergency Campaign. Go to www.afmda.org and help save lives in Israel.
Welcome back to the program. I'm Zev Brenner, coming to you from the annual Chabad Children of Chernobyl dinner in New York City.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 12th annual Children at Heart Gala. I can't believe that we're here once again, and congratulate all of you, for today we've rescued 2,783 children. On March 11th, 2011, a tsunami devastated Japan. It killed 15,839 people, a huge percentage of them children. In Haiti, an earthquake with a catastrophic 7.0 magnitude killed over 300,000 people, over half of them children. And 2011 was the deadliest year for tornadoes in the U.S. alone since 1936. 324 deaths, most of them children. The task seems very overwhelming. But take a deep breath, relax. We think that we have a solution. See, we of Children of Chernobyl, we found that we just take baby steps, take small little steps. With the money that we raised last year alone, we rescued 4 plane loads of children. We watched as 3 beautiful brides married, young girls from Chernobyl. They started their own lives. We served 1,095 nutritious meals. We bought over 300 pairs of sneakers. We kissed and we hugged over 100 children as they arrived off the planes looking lost and forlorn. See, you can make a difference. With the money raised tonight, we'll save another 100 children.
Arthur Doner, the president of Component Assembly Systems, is with us. He's coming for at least 12 years to the Chabad Children Chernobyl dinner. So welcome. What brings you to the dinner every year?
Every year, I'm a big fan and supporter of Jody Durst, the Durst organization. We're an interior contractor. We do a lot of work with them, and I think it's a worthy cause, and enjoy coming here. That's basically the reason being.
What do you enjoy most about the dinners?
I think it's a lively affair. It's for a good cause, and I think Jody's doing a fine job. I know he's involved, and again, I'm supporting Jody Durst, Component Assembly Systems, which is our company, and come here every year.
Terrific. Is there any of your favorite celebrities that you have over the 12 years you've been coming that you've enjoyed seeing?
Yeah, I've had numerous conversations with Jon Voight, Joe Torre when he's been here, several other people, but those are the two main guys that I remember and spoke to. So.
Terrific. I'm so many years to come. That's the first time that I've seen. We've been filming for the last 12 years.
Have you really?
Yes. I'm surprised we didn't grab you till now.
Well, thanks for the opportunity to be on television, and I appreciate it. Thank you
very much.
My
pleasure. Thank you. Rabbi David Herman joined us 25 years as chaplain in the United States Army, and his daughter, Esti, is a coordinator director of Chabad in Chernobyl. So welcome. Good to see you.
Thank you very much. I'm always delighted to come here and be a part of this wonderful, outstanding, delightful event.
Tell us about 25 years in the chaplain in the Army. What was that like?
It was the most exciting thing that I could have done after I received my smicha, my ordination from Rabbi Isaac Elchanan Theological Seminary.
Which is known as university, okay.
Right. And at that time, we were all obligated to give at least 2 years to our country, serve our country as a chaplain, military rabbi. And I was happy to do that. But after 2 years, I had so much fun and so much annoy. And I felt that I did so much kiruv that I said, I want to stay on.
So where did you serve? Which countries?
Which countries?
And which wars?
I had 14 different assignments, two of them in Germany, one of them in Nuremberg, one of them in Munich, one in Ansbach, all over Germany, as well as northern Italy, where we had our troops, and also Vietnam. So I have my 14 different assignments. Each one was better than the other.
What years were you in Germany?
I was in Germany from 1960 to 63, and that was just when things were heating up with the Russians because of the Cuban situation with the missiles that they were stationing there, which were 90 miles off from the coast of Florida. And I was there the second time from 73 to 76, and I was a division chaplain of one of the most outstanding divisions we have in the United States Army, Old Ironsides. And I'm wearing the cufflings of this Old Ironsides.
What about any medal? I'm surprised you're not here wearing some.
No, I wouldn't wear my medals, but I was given the Legion of Merit, the Bronze Star, the Army Commendation Medal, the Air Medal. More than I think I deserve. The HaKadosh Baruch Hu. HaKadosh Baruch Hu was good to me, to my family, and all of my kinderlach, even though we were in a non-Jewish atmosphere, grew up to be yeshiva kids, and here Esther is a product of that Stern College in yeshiva.
When, before I let you go, being in the Army, I would assume there weren't too many Orthodox Jewish chaplains at the time that you were serving, correct?
Yeshiva... Every yeshiva had to put in a certain amount of rabbis. Each one had a quota. I would think our quota of yeshiva was about 4 to 6 a year. Then you had the reform. You had the Jewish Theological Seminary, which is conservative, Hebrew Union College. It was really a united type of a situation.
Everybody got along, the Orthodox, conservative, reform.
There's no such a thing as you're better than me, I'm better than you, you're not really that way, I'm really... No, we are really yachad. We're together, and that's where our strength comes.
And was it easy to get kosher food and to provide provisions for the soldiers in different theaters of action?
Baruch Hashem, everything was supplied by the Jewish Welfare Board. I don't know if you heard.
Sure.
Oh, yes, you did. Okay, the Jewish Welfare Board took care of Jewish personnel in the military, and there was also the Army took care of the special rations called kosher MREs, meals ready to eat, MREs.
As opposed to K-rations.
As opposed to K.
I salute you.
Thank you very much. Nice meeting you. And
likewise.
I wish you hatzlocha and brochas and kol tov.
Children of Chernobyl is an organization that does not look to build campuses. They don't look for publicity. They simply want to take children who are sick and less fortunate from the devastated Chernobyl area and give them a new life and opportunity. Secondly, I'm in the food business, and I witness every day firsthand the massive amounts of food that go to waste in our normal course of everyday lives. And then I see these children who can't even afford a morsel of bread that is not contaminated. We hardly realize the bounty that is given to us. And it's times like this that I know I share this bounty with those unfortunate children.
Josh Shaktovsky is with us. He is getting the Young Leadership Award at tonight's Chabad Shul in Chernobyl. He's involved in the food business. So yes. Welcome, Mazel Tov.
Thank you.
And I understand that you're, even though you're involved in a lot of dough, right?
I am in the pizza business. I have two pizza shops, and as well as import bread from Israel, gluten-free, and among other items. But yes, I do deal with a lot of dough.
So how does it feel getting the Young Leadership Award for the Chabad Shul in Chernobyl dinner?
It's definitely a privilege. I know they don't do this every year, so it's definitely an honor, and I'm definitely humbled by this. But hopefully I'll hold up to the expectations of what they're looking for tonight.
And I think that's nice to see a lot of new people, young people are getting involved in the Chabad Shul in Chernobyl.
That's basically what the focus is. I'm also president of the New Leadership Board, and we run events. We have monthly meetings. We run events basically a few times a year, specifically to encourage younger generations to get involved, because by the time they're older, they're already involved somewhere that their parents were. So this gives them a chance to really get into a new option, basically, of a new charity or a new something that they believe in their own. And it's, thank God, we've actually been pretty successful with putting it together so far.
So you got a lot of your friends involved?
I am working on it. I pushed a lot of them here tonight to introduce them to the organization. I'm sure this is a bad venue because it's a very nice, fun event, and it's a lot of work, not just partying. So hopefully they'll stick around for the long run, and we'll get some more out of them.
Well, knowing you, I'm sure that you're going to get them motivated to continue and helping a wonderful organization like the Chabad Shul in Chernobyl. Oh,
of course. I definitely, I've grabbed a few of them in more long term, but the idea is to make some of them into more full-time involvement, and to really spread it out to a new area of, generations to really help grow that side of it.
Mazel tov to you again. Much continued success.
Thank you very much.
We're going to be right back with our very special broadcast originating from the Chabad Children of Chernobyl dinner in New York City.
Are you in business, a store owner, wholesaler, or manufacturer? Do you know you may be eligible for free television and radio advertising? Millions of dollars are lost every year by businesses not taking advantage of free radio and television advertising. Don't lose out. Advertising is the lifeline of any business, large or small. For free consultation, call us in the New York area, 212-769-1925. Out of New York, 866-MY-TV-SHOW.
If you have diabetes and love food, pay attention to this free offer.
Hi, I'm Nicole Johnson, Miss America 1999. I've had diabetes since 1993, and I hate boring food. Well, I got these three free cookbooks with fantastic tasting recipes for people with diabetes. If you have diabetes and have Medicare, you can get these cookbooks free.
Call now to qualify for not one, not two, but three free cookbooks. Call 1-800-753-6314.
You'll love this rich chocolate cake, oven-fried chicken, and nachos. You'll also get this free meal planning guide and diabetes magazine. So call now for your free Better Care Kit with three free cookbooks.
To qualify, call 1-800-753-6314. That's 1-800-753-6314.
Welcome back to the program. I'm Zev Brenner, coming to you from the annual Chabad Children of Chernobyl dinner in New York City.
It's my great honor and pleasure to be with you here, of course, to celebrate who I see are very important heroes, who are responsible for the survival and well-being of thousands of children rescued from the deadly pollution of the Chernobyl disaster. We welcome everyone here this evening. If not for all your giving hearts, this great work would not be possible. Nothing would be possible. We're also honored to have tonight two great movie legends, Kirk Douglas and his wonderful son, Michael. And I've been to Israel this year, and having visited the miracle of saving these children, it was sad for me not to visit with Yossi Reitschik. But he has so many wonderful new soldiers, young and old, carrying on his work.
One of the highlights of my year when I see Jon Voight with his prayer shawl.
This is so nice. It's so wonderful to be here, huh?
We miss you, I know.
It's amazing. Look at what they do. Every year it becomes more of an extravaganza, more beautiful. It's great.
What's new in your life?
What's new in your life?
I'm here with you.
I've got a movie coming out, and I've got a lot of work to do, so I'm very happy. I'm blessed.
Yeah, I love seeing you every year, not only here, but also in the Chabad Telethon.
Yeah, well, that's been my honor to be part of that as well. Listen, we're here, you know, raising money for this extraordinary thing that's happened. You know, when a disaster strikes, Americans and Jewish people, of course, are the first to step up and say, we want to help. And when I saw the disaster many years ago, I wanted to do something, but I had no way to express myself. And then I did a movie called Chernobyl, The Final Warning. It was a television miniseries. And I played a doctor who went over there. It was a true story. And then I learned more about it. And then I really wanted to do something to help these kids in this area. And I found out about this organization, and I've been with it ever since. And thank God for this organization. It does an amazing work. And if you were in Israel, as I was, visiting with these children, you would be deeply moved and very proud that you were able to provide a survival, but also a really a healthy future for these so many children.
Ladies and gentlemen,
it's amazing the work that is done.
For our program, our auction host will assist you in bidding from your seats.
It's a direction.
Amazing.
By the way,
that's God.
That's God speaking,
get
right?
Your seat.
But you should know, and by the way, you not only have been involved, they call you a Lama Vavnik, one of the 36 righteous people on whose sake the world survived, that you also bring many people.
I know a lot of those guys.
You know, and you bring them some.
I know a couple of those guys.
Introduce me.
I wouldn't put myself in the same level, but I've been privileged to know some great, great people.
But you also brought some
of
the...
And a lot of, you know, the guys here tonight, a lot of these people are here tonight.
Thank you. And you bring so many people also, so many celebrities to join the Chabad dinner.
Well, it's fun. I mean, all you have to do is make one introduction to the Chabad and they're dancing forever.
Exactly.
That's it.
I don't know how they wonder how you get them to do it, but you do it.
Nothing. I just tell them the good work they're doing. They know I'm sincere. And most, you know, and people in Hollywood, they're looking to help. They're always looking to help people.
But you're willing to dance, because I asked Larry King if he'll dance like you. He said no, he won't dance.
Well, he could dance with me.
I'll
ask him.
Thank you. Zygazun, thank you.
Zygazun.
I should feel boxed in, but I don't. Yuri Foreman is from Russia. He's the first Israeli world champion in boxing, right?
Yes. How are you doing?
Good.
Not a very typical profession for a Jewish boy.
Yes, true. Well, times are changing, you know.
What, there are more Jews being involved in boxing now?
Apparently more immigrants in this country, so that's the secret ingredient and sweet science.
How did you get involved in boxing?
When I was a kid, I've been bullied a few times back in Russia, and my mom took me to boxing gym and started all back then.
And I also believe that you are observant, so did that propose any challenges for you during boxing?
Well, no fights till sundown, so on Saturday. And of course, you know, the diet and other than that, you know, I don't want to hurt my opponents neither, so.
Oh, you don't hit them too hard, right?
Too hard, that's right. Yeah.
Just enough to knock them out, but not to really do a real blow to them.
Exactly.
And what other challenge have you have being religious and being a boxer?
Only advantages, no challenges anymore.
Only advantages?
Yes.
And did you also have a relationship with Lubavitcher Rebbe?
I never met him, I'm connected with the Chabad, with the Lubavitch, and different organization and Jewry. You know, every Jew is like, you know, we have same blood.
Sure. It was wonderful to see you again.
Thank you very much.
Good, thank you.
Thank you.
William Hochman is the CEO of the Joel Paul Group. They're an employment agency. First time that he's here. Good to see you.
Nice to see you, Zev. Thank you for having me.
What brings you to the Chabad Shul in Chernobyl?
So, several agendas. One, my good friend Esty Herman is the executive director. And being in the nonprofit sector, we service organizations like Children of Chernobyl and other Jewish and secular organizations for placement of executives, fundraisers, development.
I thought maybe you're looking for maybe a down on his luck actor or a celebrity that's looking for another job. Or
if they can fundraise for a Jewish organization, we'll get them a job.
So is that primarily your focus on getting fundraisers for Jewish groups?
Well, today most organizations are looking for development and fundraisers. We also do CFOs, directors of technology, whatever position is needed in a nonprofit, we can service them. But with today's economy and looking for donors and money, the primary responsibilities that they're looking for are executive directors and fundraisers.
When you say Joe Paul, I'm thinking of the old WVD song, Joe and Paul, right? Is that where it came from?
So there is really a Mr. Joe Paul. He should live and be well. He's my president. He comes to work every day. And just my partner and myself bought the organization from Joel about 2 years ago. So we're having a good time. We look forward to meeting a lot of clients and candidates and servicing the Jewish and secular nonprofit world.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Zev.
You get to see everybody, Jewish world, political world, celebrity world. Rabbi Avrumi Jordan is Director of Operations for Gateways. Good to see you.
Good to see you too, Zev.
So first time you're here at Chabad in Chernobyl?
First time here. I've heard a lot about it, tremendous things and the work that they're doing, and wanted to come and see firsthand for myself what it was.
So your impressions, it's a massive, this is one of the big dinners of the year.
Yeah, it's incredible. You see, it's a first-class act over here. It's really tremendous what they're doing, and you can learn a lot from these guys.
They do a wonderful job.
Yeah, I wish them tremendous hatzlacha in all that they do.
Thank you.
Thanks, Eliza.
At the Chabad Shul in Chernobyl, I get this not only other friends, but also family members. My sister, Michelle Brenner, financial IT consultant. Good to see you here at the dinner.
Thank you, Zev. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you.
So your impression, I know it's not the first time you've been here. What are your impressions? I know it's one of your favorite Jewish dinners of the year.
I look forward to this every year. I think it's a great cause for the children of Chernobyl. I think it's a very well-run event, and the people are marvelous, and I enjoy being here. Especially with such a great host of the show, how could I not show up?
With that, you're going to get invited again next year to be on camera.
There you go. Well, save me a seat. I appreciate that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
We're going to be right back with our very special broadcast originating from the Chabad Children of Chernobyl dinner in New York City.
You won't find someone who loves Sharif Satar Davot more than me. The staff here is wonderful. They treat him like a friend. Mr. and Mrs. Shah have helped me so many times. Anytime I had a question, they were like the first people I would call, and it was like calling, you know, a good friend that gave you advice from the heart.
As soon as I walked into Sharif Satar Davot, I said, this is it for my mother. Everybody was so lovely and warm, and there were so many activities, and I saw this atmosphere, this ambience immediately.
Everybody and anybody in the neighborhood walks in all the time to visit, to cheer up the people, to have nachas, to see a place run so well.
A lot of people don't know this about my mother. She ran facilities in Ohio for senior citizens. I think that this is God rewarding her now, being in a place where she's having such good care.
My parents really needed someone to give them the love that this place was able to give them.
Can you read my number?
Attention those on Medicare with diabetes. You may be eligible for an upgraded meter.
I am tired of stabbing my fingertips to test my blood glucose. There has got to be a better way.
If you're on Medicare with diabetes, then you need to know there's a new method for checking your blood glucose. You don't need to stab your fingertips anymore. This new Embrace meter is easier to use and nearly painless. And the best news? Is that Diabetes Care Club will send you one of these new meters.
This new method hurts less, and I don't have to stab my fingertips anymore.
Not only can I see my number, I can hear it too.
Your blood glucose reading is 89.
There's my number.
Find out why nearly a quarter of a million patients have joined Diabetes Care Club.
Call Diabetes Care Club.
Shipping is free, and so is the call.
Call 1-800-521-7697.
I'm glad I did.
Welcome back to the program. I'm Zev Brenner, coming to you from the annual Chabad Children of Chernobyl dinner in New York City.
I should be giving all of those involved an award for the 365 days they work on behalf of the children, an award for allowing me to do chesed in a most meaningful way, and allowing me to get to know all of you and never forgetting the man who got me involved, and that is our beautiful Yossi Rajcik. Life is not measured by the number of breaths we take, but the moments that take our breath away. This sure for me is one of those moments. I thank you all, and let's do one thing, let's party. Thank you.
It's a yearly ritual, one of my favorite listeners, right? Elaine Gold, a member of the board, Chabad and Chernobyl. You were on our TV show every year too, so good to see you.
Yes, I have been. Who would miss this kind of event? Who would miss giving back to children in Chernobyl? Who would miss this unbelievable party?
How many years have you been coming?
About 10, 12. And it gets better each year. The mission becomes more important each year. What we do for the kids is even more important each year. And it's the best way of giving back.
How'd you get involved in the first place?
I met Yossi Rajcik.
That's the answer, right? He was the man that built
Nothing
it.
Nothing more to say. I did somebody a favor. I went to Kfar Chabad to say hello, and that was it. And I've been hooked.
You've been hooked. May you continue for many more years to come to join us here at the Chabad Chon Chernobyl dinner.
Thank you.
We're with Ezra Freelander, the CEO of the Freelander Group. They do wonderful work in public relations and governmental relations. And Ezra not only puts on a lot of different events, but attends. So good to see you, Ezra. How are you enjoying yourself tonight?
I'm enjoying it tremendously. I was here last year, as the year before.
And the year before.
And the year before. But last year was very special because my wife called me from the labor room that I better rush over because the baby's about to make his grand entrance. I literally ran from here, grabbed a taxi, and flew to Maimonides Hospital. So it's my son's first birthday just around this time of the year.
Happy birthday to your son, right?
Thank you, thank you.
And they do wonderful work. I know that you are so involved in the Jewish community. So one of the reasons I know you like coming is because of the good work that the Chabad Children's Chernobyl does.
Absolutely. It's for most people, the disaster in Chernobyl is just something that you read about in the history books. But for Chabad Children of Chernobyl, it's something that they face every day. And they don't read about it, they acted upon it. And it's an organization that everyone should support because what they do is literally take lives that would have been wasted and bring them to Israel, educate them, give them proper medical attention, and forever they're part of our community for generations to come.
That they are saving lives. Before I let you go, I want to thank you publicly because you have spearheaded, one person, you, has spearheaded an attempt to have Raoul Wallenberg honored with a Medal of Honor at the, in Congress. So tell us about that.
Well, Congress introduced it was sponsored in the House and in the Senate. It's a bipartisan effort to award Raoul Wallenberg with the highest civilian honor, the Congressional Gold Medal, in honor of his upcoming centennial of his birth. And we hope that by then the legislation will be passed and a public event will highlight the importance of Raoul Wallenberg's life's mission, which was to save the remnants of Holocaust survivors, and he did that.
Tremendous job, Eric. Ezra, thank you for the wonderful work you're doing, and with God's help, you're gonna see that come to fruition.
Thank you, and you'll be there, Zev.
God willing, I won't miss it.
Thank you.
Malcolm Holine, Executive Vice Chair of the Conference of Presidents of Major American Jewish Organizations. Good to see you again.
It's good to be here and see you. Our annual encounter at Pier 60.
I know that
for a great cause.
Really a wonderful cause, and you're so involved in the Jewish community, so you know good causes when you see it. What's on your plate these days? There's so much going on in the Jewish community.
Right now, I'd like to have hamburger on my plate, but
it can easily be arranged.
But you didn't allow that, so. I mean, look, it's a very hectic time, a very difficult time with all the developments in the Middle East, with the issues that are arising regarding Iran's nuclear program, the economic problems, which have political implications as well. Obviously, Israel's security remains the priority concern. So there's no shortage of issues right now.
No, I know, Malcolm, that you're working on this certainly with God's help come to some resolution, because certainly we live in dangerous times, a lot of challenges that are facing the Jewish community, also facing our country.
We certainly are. I just came from Washington straight here and had meetings there. And the problem is, no matter how much time you have for the meeting, there's not enough because of the number of issues and the complexity of the issues, whether it's Turkey, Iran, Syria, Egypt, Tunisia, whether it's the events that are going on in Europe. I mean, there's just so much that one has to stay on top of, and it's imperative for people to keep informed, listening to your shows and watching your shows, reading the dailyalert.org, by going to other sites. People have to stay on top of it because the decisions are going to be of great consequence and long-term consequence.
Now, I'm going to thank you all that you do.
My pleasure.
And bon appetit.
On to the hamburgers.
Enjoy that hamburger.
Thank you.
We have his father every year, but Neil Book joins us. I guess his father wants a new face, a new generation to be part of our broadcast. So good to see you. Welcome.
Great to see you. It's so nice to be here. Thank you.
But like your father, you're very involved in the Chabad Shul in Chernobyl.
Yes, we've been involved for a very long time. And, of course, we were originally brought in by Rabbi Yossi Reichik. And tonight always reminds me very much of him and the love and the dedication that he brought to this cause, which is really one that's very special to all of us.
What do you do in real life when you're not helping? Not that this isn't real life. Of course, they do very important work. But what do you do when you're not helping Chabad Shul in Chernobyl?
I run a technology business for Juniper Networks.
Terrific. Thank you for joining us.
And
regards to your dad.
You got it. Take care.
We're going to be right back with our very special broadcast originating from the Chabad Children of Chernobyl dinner in New York City.
Are you stressed over credit cards and other debts? Maybe through no fault of your own? Imagine how it would feel to have that weight lifted right off your shoulders. Well, here's some good news from America's trusted name in debt relief. Care One providers have already helped over 4.5 million people in debt, and we can help you today. Just call this toll-free number to speak with a friendly representative, and in just minutes, you'll get your free debt relief analysis.
Just call the toll-free number today.
Is getting a good night's sleep getting impossible?
Well, not anymore.
Introducing Side Sleeper Pro. It's much more than a good night's sleep. The secret is Side Sleeper Pro's doctor-developed ergonomic patented design to help support the neck and spine. Here's how it works. Watch as Side Sleeper Pro guides your head, neck, and vertebrae into natural alignment, relieving pressure on the neck while unrestricting airways. The tail cradles your back to ensure correct posture. Now, you can wake with less stiffness and feel rested thanks to improve sleep posture. Side Sleeper Pro is only $39.99 and it's guaranteed to work. But wait, order right now and we'll cut the price to $19.99. Plus, order now and we'll include a washable cotton pillowcase for free. Order online at sidesleeperpro.com and we'll include an inflatable travel pillow, perfect for when you're on the go. For only $19.99, you'll get the Side Sleeper Pro pillowcase and travel pillow, a $100 value, but you must order now.
Agent MS is the great new video series for Jewish kids that educates while it entertains. Shimi Epstein is a typical yeshiva boy, but when the forces of evil strike, led by their fiendish leader, Dr. Lotov, Shimi transforms into the awesome Agent MS. The Forward recommends Agent MS as a perfect gift, reporting that in their experience, kids just eat it up. Agent MS is now out in 3 great episodes. Find it in your local Judaica store, or check out their website at agent-ms.com, or call 1-888-MS-123.
Welcome back to the program. I'm Zev Brenner, coming to you from the annual Chabad Children of Chernobyl dinner in New York City.
Dakota and Elle have really rocked the film world. They have incredible hits under their young belts, and they have really bright futures. And they are still very down to earth and very giving. And that is really a special piece of them. Obviously, it comes from very good parenting, because they have adopted the give back theory. They know they've been blessed, they are creative, and they know that they need to help take care of people that are not as blessed as they are.
When I was learning about Chernobyl, I realized how brave all these kids are. I mean, I sort of tried to put myself in their place, and I mean, them being, you know, very sick, and they're leaving their families, you know, they're going on this plane to this new country, they don't know what to expect, and never been there before, and they really have to put like all their trust into these, you know, caring people who are going to make them better, and they're like role models to me, because, you know, they're reminding me of the importance of health, and I'm just so happy that I get to help these kids, you know, be safer and healthier. And Dakota and I just want to thank you guys so much again for thinking of us with this award, and we'd like to accept it in the honor of all the kids who are well now and the ones who still have to take that step on the airplane to a better and safer life. Thanks to all of you guys.
Nancy Spielberg joins us, a driving force behind the Chabad in Chernobyl. Good to see you again.
Thank you. Nice to see you too.
Famous family, your mother I see over here, and Stephen has been here every number of years, right?
Stephen is here many times, but this year he has a good excuse. He's in Virginia shooting Lincoln. Even though I think Lincoln is already shot, but in any case.
He wants to make sure.
Right, just make sure.
You never know these days, right? What project are you working on?
I actually just finished a documentary, Elusive Justice, which aired on PBS this week, and we actually doubled and tripled ratings for primetime PBS, so I'm excited.
We should have you on again then.
Maybe. So, and I'm working.
Tell us about the documentary.
That one was really about Nazis and Nazi hunters and crimes against humanity, and the idea.
Well, we just had Elizabeth Holzman, who she was part of your.
So she was in my film, so I love her. She is really such an incredible woman that she had the chutzpah to stand up in a group of men and put that together and bring out the whole Holtzman legislation was really the only thing we had in this country to fight against the Nazis, to get them out of
Ladies
this country.
And gentlemen,
it's wonderful. What other projects? You're starting something else too. I know you're not just finished with one project and say, that's it, right? You're working on something else.
Yeah, there's always something cooking. This one is actually about the Israeli Air Force, but I'll get into it with you later. I can't talk about the whole thing yet, but it's a great story. I'm very, very in love and supportive of Israel, so if I can do anything that shows Israel's strengths and power, I'd love it. So that's what I'm starting.
Is there any way to get more celebrities in Hollywood to support Israel? Because there are some, but we need more of them coming out. I was shocked when I heard I did a show on the Yiddish theater and about Jews on Broadway, how many Broadway stars came out for Ben Hecht, for Perfidy. And I looked at the name and I said, wow, we don't have anything comparable today.
You know, I think it's really a tough sell. Hollywood is very left. And, you know, it's a constant discussion in our family because I always say to my brother, you know, why can't you get Hollywood to get more involved in Israel? And he's to the right of most of Hollywood. You know, he loves Israel. He's very supportive of Israel. But for some reason, that liberal California stuff and, you know, it's a tough call. It really is tough. I mean, listen, I get a great amount of celebrities at this event. And here, Israel's a part of this because not only, I mean, it's a humanitarian cause, we save children, but we bring them to Israel. And somebody has to be okay with that, you know. And I still get a lot of Hollywood supporting this cause, knowing that we're bringing these kids into Israel. So it is very tough to get them politically supportive. We're working on it.
All right. I think it'll be great. And if anybody can do it, Nancy Spielberg can do it, right?
But I'm trying. I'll just beat them up.
Thank you for joining us again.
Wonderful to see you. Okay.
What can I say? Two of my favorite people, Harvey and Glory Cayley. I see them at a lot of different dinners, right? But the one thing I see them always at Chabad Shul and Chernobyl dinner every year. So good to see you again. I know you're involved in so many causes. What makes Chabad Shul and Chernobyl so special to you?
Well, for what it does and for its helping children, and children is our future. So what more can we say that... when we can help our children going further, it's our obligation and our commitment.
I know, Gloria, you're also very into children and outreach and doing for our people, right?
For me, outreach, and for me, the children, they're the most important because they're the future. And for me, it's as basic as that. So
I know you're philanderers, you're very involved in Jewish. But what disturbs me, maybe you give us some insight, is according to the surveys, the newer generation of philanthropists and then the Jewish community are not giving money to Jewish causes. They're giving everything but Jewish causes. How do we motivate the younger generation that are philanthropists to dedicate and to do more for education, for kids, for outreach, you name the Jewish cause?
Well, I think to begin with, I think the Jewish children have to go to day schools to begin with, okay, to get them involved with Judaism. So, and what I call it is that they then become part of the Jewish club. And then no matter where they go in the world, they're part of the Jewish club. Okay? And then they decide what they're going to do. And then they have an understanding about Judaism. So that's what I think is important.
I think it's important, but unfortunately, with today's economy, I'm speaking to a lot of parents that not only are not sending the kids that ordinarily would, some are even pulling the kids out of yeshivas and sending them to public schools.
But I have to say, we're involved with the Yeshiva HaTorah. And in these times, we know We know things are tough. Yet within these tough times, they're growing. And I believe one of the reasons they're growing is that there's an involvement by the parent body. So it's not just a few people supporting it big time, but rather spread out over everyone. And for example, when they needed help, there was a contribution of matching funds, but there were some conditions. It had to be 100% involvement by all the parents. It's not how much, but giving.
Even they got to give something according to their means.
Look, even people on scholarship had to give. And the end result was they got 100% contributions from everybody. And that's what makes it strong when people get involved. You get involved in different ways. It doesn't only mean money. It means time, effort, thinking, doing, and that's what I think we have to do. So to answer your question, I think you need exposure for kids to see what's going on. And I have to tell you, the best thing about giving, it's like an investment. But usually in an investment, you have to wait for a return over a number of years. What's nice, what we do, we see the return almost immediately by the repercussions, by the results of what we're doing. So we look at it as good investors.
Terrific. Now, kudos. I know you speak with a passion about, you know, your shul, you're the Hampton Shul, and about the education of the kids. And I just hope more people learn from you and emulate. And that's why we're glad that you're on. I know that you're always reluctant to come on. We don't want to publish what we do, but I think it's important that people hear, because we need more people to get involved and to do as you're doing and motivate people to be involved in our community for the sake of Israel, for the sake of Jewry.
To give you an idea, my granddaughter just got bat mitzvah.
Mazel tov.
Thank you. She's collecting plastic bottles, and she lives in Israel. She's collecting plastic bottles. I ask her, what are you going to do with the money? Because you get money for it. Said she's giving it to tzedakah. That's how you get kids involved. By my daughter takes them. When we get involved with something, they come along and they see. And the kids are smart.
No, they pick up.
Yes.
Thank you, and continue success.
All the best to you, Zev. You keep it up.
Pammy Brenner joins us again. She's actually a very good video producer, does some wonderful videos. And every year it's a tradition that she comes with me, as with our other daughter, Lizzie, to the Chabad Children of Chernobyl did in New York City. So good to have you back. How are you enjoying this year?
I'm having a great time. And just the food, everything is great.
So which celebrity did you see tonight?
I saw Jon Voight, Mrs. Spielberg, Catherine Zeta-Jones.
That's a great place to see celebrities and also just general people. So very big crowd.
Yeah.
We look forward to you ready for next year. Ready, right?
Of course.
Thank you, Pamela.
Thank you.
We're going to be right back with our very special broadcast originating from the Chabad Children of Chernobyl dinner in New York City.
You won't find someone who loves Sharv Satyaravot more than me. The staff here is wonderful. They treat him like a friend. Mr. and Mrs. Shah have helped me so many times. Anytime I had a question, they were like the first people I would call, and it was like calling, you know, a good friend that gave you advice from the heart.
As soon as I walked into Sharv's Ateret Avot, I said, this is it for my mother. Everybody was so lovely and warm, and there were so many activities, and I saw this atmosphere, this ambience immediately.
Everybody and anybody in the neighborhood walks in all the time to visit, to cheer up the people, to have nachas, to see a place run so well.
A lot of people don't know this about my mother. She ran facilities in Ohio for senior citizens. I think that this is God rewarding her now, being in a place where she's having such good care.
My parents really needed someone to give them the love that this place was able to give them.
Can you read my number?
Attention those on Medicare with diabetes. You may be eligible for an upgraded meter.
I am tired of stabbing my fingertips to test my blood glucose. There has got to be a better way.
If you're on Medicare with diabetes, then you need to know there's a new method for checking your blood glucose. You don't need to stab your fingertips anymore. This new Embrace meter is easier to use and nearly painless. And the best news is that Diabetes Care Club will send you one of these new meters.
This new method hurts less, and I don't have to stab my fingertips anymore.
Not only can I see my number, I can hear it too.
Your blood glucose reading is 89.
There's my number.
Find out why nearly 250,000 patients have joined Diabetes Care Club.
Call Diabetes Care Club.
Shipping is free, and so is the call.
Call 1-800-521-7697.
I'm glad I did.
Welcome back to the program. I'm Zev Brenner, coming to you from the annual Chabad Children of Chernobyl dinner in New York City.
I was incredibly touched that Dad and his lovely wife, Anne, have agreed to come here tonight to accept this honor. Now, I think most all of you know that both my father and I have had some physical challenges over the last few years, so that's why it is particularly special for me that we stand here together this evening. Because I think the older we get, the more that we understand the value of family. And the children in the Chernobyl region would never be able to experience these feelings if it wasn't for the help of this great organization, because we are their family. But what you probably don't know about my father and Anne is that through their Douglas Foundation, they have created over 400 playgrounds in conjunction with the Los Angeles School District. Thank you. In fact, there's also a soccer field in Israel that has been built benefiting both Israeli and Arab children. And why I'm so happy here tonight is to announce that as part of their program, in honor of my father, I'd like to sponsor the 401st Anne and Kirk Douglas Playground, and it's going to be in Israel on the campus of the Children of Chernobyl. So when I say tonight, Isya, I love you, and I'm very proud of you. At the same time, my thoughts go out to the children at Chernobyl.
My mother and father were Russian immigrants from Belarus, and they lived a little settlement that was decimated by the Nazi. And we might have had many relatives in Belarus, but we lost track of all of them from the Second World War. But Belarus, as you know, borders Chernobyl, and most of the contamination goes to Belarus. So I was thinking, maybe I have a niece that I don't know who got contaminated by Chernobyl, and maybe she has cancer. I like to think that my niece, with the help of Chabad, Children of Chernobyl, was transported to Israel and has taken care of, and there she has a new life. I congratulate Chabad, Children of Chernobyl, for all the good work they do. I congratulate them, and I thank you for inviting me here tonight. Thank you.
Former Congresswoman Elizabeth Holzman joins us, very involved in also fighting Nazi war criminals and prosecuting them. And great to have you. What brings you to the first time to the Chabad Children Chernobyl dinner?
Well, Nancy Spielberg is the producer of a documentary about Nazi war criminals, and I was in it. So I got to meet her, and very interested in coming and participating. My family, both my parents came from Eastern Europe, not too far from Chernobyl, my dad from Pinsk, and my mom from outside of Kiev. So I feel for the people who are there, and I think this is a very good cause.
Certainly is. What was the documentary about? To give us some more details.
The documentary is called Elusive Justice. It was about Nazi war criminals. And because I was responsible in the United States for setting up the whole apparatus for getting the government to start bringing them to justice, they interviewed me in this movie. So it was on Channel 13 recently.
Terrific. Good to see you. And is there another book in the offing?
Maybe. Maybe I'll write a book about my experiences in tracking down Nazis.
I think that because it seems that we're almost at the end of the line as far as tracking down Nazis in the United States, right?
Right. But we can't stop till a job is finished. And then there's still history to be told. Because there's still history behind the Iron Curtain that was never done. The Holocaust is never really studied in Eastern Europe properly and recorded, so there's still work to be done like that. And, of course, to take testimony from the victims.
Thank you for the important work that you're doing, and look forward to having you back.
Thanks so much. Thank you.
Sherman Katz, the hardworking spouse of Nancy Spielberg. And we've had Nancy every year. I think we missed you a couple years, right?
Yeah. I run around a lot, and she's supposed to be in the limelight, so I'm behind her.
But from what I understand, this is one of the most, if not the most successful Chabad Chernobyl dinner?
This is a great... First of all, we got the youngest icon in Hollywood and the oldest icon in Hollywood. There's 80-some-odd years between them, 82 years between them. And so it's a great thing to watch.
So who's the youngest icon in Hollywood?
Elle Fanning. Elle Fanning is here to accept the Children of the World Award for her and her sister, Dakota. Elle Fanning was just in Super 8 and broke all kinds of records, and Dakota's been in everything. These two women are unbelievable. Jon Voight, actually, I don't know if you saw Jon before. Jon said that he has never seen two such young and talented actresses. So... He's a maven in the crowd.
And you got him here, and of course, the oldest icon of Hollywood is...
Kirk Douglas. Right, we got Kirk Douglas over here,
his
right?
Second or third bar mitzvah?
He's working on his third. And Michael, his son. And Michael is actually, you will see Michael is going to dedicate a playground in Israel in honor of his father tonight. So it's a wonderful thing. I think it's going on now in the background.
It's wonderful because there's a commitment. You see that from Kirk and Michael. There's a commitment to Israel. And, of course, who can forget those films, Cast a Giant Shadow and the other ones?
Right. And they both love Israel very much. And they're very, very committed, like you said. And Michael gives us money regularly. And Kirk also supports a lot of Israeli causes. And this is it's wonderful that we were able to get them together. Stephen was supposed to be here. Stephen is shooting in Virginia. And so Stephen was supposed to come last night.
That's Steven Spielberg, if people...
I'm sorry. We know him as Stephen. Steven Spielberg was supposed to come
What's
last
his Hebrew
night.
Name?
He was Shmuel.
Shmuel Spielberg, okay.
Right. Shmuel. He'll tell you the stories about when they used to yell at him, Shmuel, down. His grandfather used to yell, Shmuel, and he wouldn't turn around.
Until they called him Stephen.
Well, the neighbors were, he didn't want the neighbors to let him know that he was Jewish, and his grandfather used to say, Shmuel, Shmuel. And so he wouldn't turn around until the neighbors, if it was somebody else. Now I think he's actually pretty proud of it. He's very committed to Jewish causes as well.
So the next movie won't say Steven Spielberg, will say Shmuel Spielberg, right?
Shmuel Spielberg. So Shmuel Spielberg had a screening last night of his new movie that's coming out in about 2 weeks called War Horse. He has two coming out, Tintin and War Horse. And so he was supposed to be last night at the screening, the premiere screening, and he couldn't come. And he was supposed to be here with us. He couldn't come because he's a little behind on shooting schedule of Lincoln, which is his new movie that's coming out next year. So he did make a video real quick. And he's pretty good on the video. He stumbles a little on Tikkun Olam, but otherwise he's got...
We got to come for Friday night dinner and we'll straighten him out,
right?
But if he calls himself Shmuel, the Tikkun Olam will follow gradually.
I think he's proud of Shmuel now, you know? He really is. Yeah, things have changed.
Terrific. So thank you for all the good work that you're doing.
Thank you.
And the hard work and effort that you and Nancy put in for the Chabad Shalom Chernobyl.
Always wonderful to see you.
We're going to be right back with our very special broadcast originating from the Chabad Children of Chernobyl dinner in New York City.
Mixshoot Productions proudly presents The Yidio Video Show, a weekly half-hour show featuring a variety of Jewish music videos hosted by Saul. Catch your favorite Jewish music stars every week on the Time Warner Manhattan Channel 35, Fridays 10:30 to 11 a.m. and Sundays 4:30 to 5 p.m., part of the Talkline Communications Network.
Are you stressed over credit cards and other debts? Maybe through no fault of your own? Imagine how it would feel to have that weight lifted right off your shoulders. Well, here's some good news from America's trusted name in debt relief. Care One providers have already helped over 4.5 million people in debt, and we can help you today. Just call this toll-free number to speak with a friendly representative, and in just minutes, you'll get your free debt relief analysis.
Just call the toll-free number today.
Are you in business? A store owner, wholesaler, or manufacturer? Do you know you may be eligible for free television and radio advertising? Millions of dollars are lost every year by businesses not taking advantage of free radio and television advertising. Don't lose out. Advertising is the lifeline of any business, large or small. For free consultation, call us in the New York area, 212-769-1925. Out of New York, 866-MY-TV-SHOW.
We hope you've enjoyed our very special broadcast originating from the Chabad Children of Chernobyl dinner in New York City. For more information about the very important work of the organization, please contact them at the address you see on screen. Join us again next week, same time, same station here on the Talkline Communications Network. I'm Zev Brenner. Shalom.
Thank you for watching Talkline with Zev Brenner, America's number one Jewish program. If you have any comments or would like more information on all of Talkline's radio and television programs nationwide, contact the Talkline Communications Network at Post Office Box 20108, Park West Station, New York, New York, 10025, or call 212-769-1925. Out of New York, call 1-800-628-TALK, that's T-A-L-K. This is the Talkline Communications Network.